From Ab Fab to Ben Elton, Jenny Eclair presents her pick and mix selection in half an hour. New comedy first on BBC Two. It's time to rub thighs with the stars.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the celebrity television quiz, Shooting Stars. And introducing Team A,
please welcome Tanya Breyer and Leo Sayer.
Tanya and Leo have just been bitten by some vipers whilst putting their hands into a soup cauldron trying to steal the bouquet garni. Don't worry, the doctor says they should last the 30 minutes required before perishing. And here is the captain of Team A, Mr. Mark Lamar. And introducing Team B, please welcome Mariella Frostrop and Anthony Worrell Thompson. The combined weight of these two is 75 years. One is 53 and the other 22. But can you guess which? And here is the captain of Team B, Mr. Ulrika Johnson. And now, please welcome your hosts for this evening, Vic Reeves and Bob Mortimer.
Welcome to Shooting Stars. This is Maria. I just met a girl called Maria, and suddenly I found how wonderful a sound can be. Yeah.
What was that about, Lindsay?
It was just a little excerpt from West Side Story.
Nice, friendly song.
It was. And Bob, you've got a West Side Story, haven't you? Because you hang permanently to the west.
Whereas I, on the other hand, Tanya, hang permanently to the north.
Do you?
You think so?
I think I've wooed her.
Guess what? The Shooting Stars, the show Busy Busy Bollocks type style quiz. Yes, that's supervised by the FBI. Can you believe that?
I can't believe that, but if you say so, big guy.
Hey, I do, big guy. Anthony?
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you for coming. Now you're... Well, what's he doing?
Get your hands on that. Just get my flask out.
It's going to be a long night.
Right, your doctor. Now, Anthony, you, of course, top chef.
Yeah.
You'd accept that, wouldn't you? Now, my mum was a chef, but she would never have worn a beard in the kitchen. She'd never have worn a beard in the kitchen. Actually, there's something in your beard.
No, it's not.
It's lovely to have you here. Who's your favourite chef, Anthony?
Gary Rhodes, probably.
I like the little chef.
Yeah, that is a little chef.
Ulrika. Lovely to have you back again, Ulrika. I see you've had your hair cut. You know, that one on your lip, out of the wart. Mariella?
No.
No? What is your name, then? It's a very unusual name. I suspect it's Fallon. Let's find out. Where are you from, Mariella?
Ireland and Norway.
Ireland and Norway?
And Scotland.
That's a pair of stirrups. In it, though.
Oh, hey, look. So, it's some Leo Sayer.
Leo Sayer. Yeah.
Is that home perm kit, or is it...?
It was my mum's.
Was it?
Yeah.
And Mark Lamar or Mark Lamour?
He's a greasy lover!
There he is.
He's Mr. 506 Trumpets!
Blowing his sexual bugle around the valleys. And then, once again, lovely Tanya Bryars. Mm.
So, there's the teams. Don't they look great? A couple of fjord dwellers and a hobbit. On this side. Fantastic! That's our guest, but there ain't no show, Vic, without him.
Who?
George Dawes, the man with the scars!
He's a baby! He
First round, as always, is true or false. Anthony, is it true or is it false? You decide.
True or false? We just don't know yet, do we? False.
Well, hold on, wait for the question. True or false? First question is for you, Anthony. True or false? More people are killed per year by donkeys than die in air crashes. Is that true or is it false?
It's true.
It is true, Anthony Wall Thompson. Hold on a second, Anthony. I meant to ask you, on Ready, Steady, Cook, you do the cooking against the clock.
Aye.
We're going to ask you to do some of that tonight, if you don't mind.
I've got the ingredients.
We've got about 25 minutes left in the show. We're going to ask you to make a fruit bomb.
Fruit bomb. I got them today.
There's your ingredients. You've got 25 minutes.
OK.
OK, if you get the ingredients out. Rush the dish, Anthony. You've got 25 minutes.
OK.
Tanya, yes. True or false? Elderly Greek women keep their stockings up by backcombing the hairs on their legs.
Is it just Greek? Is it just Greek women? True.
It is true!
Ulrika? True or false? Robert Kilroy Silk has a thread inserted into his hairline, which is pulled by his producer whenever he thinks he's about to swear. True or false?
I think that would be pretty true.
You're saying true? Let's have a look. Well done, Ulrika.
Mark. Sweaty, sweaty Mark.
He's not sweaty.
Isn't he?
No.
Oh, he must have dried off since I last handled him. Mark, true or false, at night, unknown to us humans, hens use the holes in their beaks to hold joss sticks.
Quite cool.
False.
False.
You're saying false? Well, we can find out. In fact, it's true. And here is a hen. Hold these joss sticks. Ready for the big party.
And it is a big party, I can tell you. Mariella, you're from Norway?
A bit of me is.
Really?
Yeah.
And are you? Have you got full immigration status, or, like Ulrika, should you not really be here?
Funnily enough, we were talking about that just earlier, and, yes, I am an illegal alien.
You're an illegal entrant?
No,
Ulrika's had many of them. Really? Mariella, true or false?
What?
An American surgeon was struck off when a patient discovered he'd used a fire extinguisher to perform a colonic irrigation. Is it true or is it simply false?
I would have to say true.
I'm afraid it's false. I'm lucky, Mariella. Oh,
sorry.
Lucky.
I think it can be done.
No, but it's false. He was
wait,
struck
wait
off.
There.
Oh, no.
What? How powerful is your best mate? If it could be used for colonic irrigation, they'd use the tube, wouldn't it?
No, look at his bottom now.
Oh, God! I've been looking for that for ages. It's my flat iron, Ulrika.
What do you do with that then?
What do I use it for?
Yeah.
I like flatten out crow's feet and lines and forehead, you know.
How does it work?
Like this. Nice one.
Does it work then? Am I handsome now?
No, you're not really.
Oh, well, never mind.
Leo!
Lovely long Leo. Leo.
Beep, beep!
Supposed to be?
That's you!
What's that supposed to be?
It was not your song, do you not remember? No. Leo!
There's something in your hair.
It's the rest of it.
Hang on a minute.
It's a pig.
What?
Is it pig?
No!
Yeah.
That's more or less.
Leo, true or false? Middle Eastern countries are always fighting each other and getting on each other's nerves and that.
True or false, Leo?
True.
It is true, yeah.
It is true. Yeah. Well done, that's the end of the true and false round, so let's go straight up to George. George, say, what are the scores?
George Dawes.
All right, OK. OK. Teams have got two!
Hey!
Hey, Bob. Yep. Do you remember the time we were in the army?
Yes, I do. I wore a red hat.
And I wore a blue hat.
I cleaned the cannon.
And I cleaned your balls.
That's right. The next round is the...
It's always worth it, isn't it? It's always worth a shot, Mark. You must know that.
That was He's almost... a greasy lover. Now, next round is the clips round. There's one clip. I want both teams to watch it very carefully. The question comes after the clip. And it's an open round, so we really want to see your fingers.
There she is, face. She's being held hostage by the communists. It looks like they're kind of pushing and pulling her about a bit.
What do you mean, they're pushing and pulling her around, Hannibal?
Hey, we'll show you.
Kind of like this.
Huh? This kind of movement.
Push? Pull? Huh? We gotta get in there and save her!
You're darn tootin'.
Wait a minute. We got dynamite. We're gonna have to modify the van.
That's fine, Tom, but what are we gonna modify it with?
Ah, fresh and clean and nicely spruced up.
What do you got in your little Burberry wash bag, Mr. T?
You ain't looking at my Burberry wash bag, fool.
Hey, wait a minute! We gotta modify the van. There's a lady over there being pushed and pulled a bit by communists.
Pushing and pulling her? Here, have the bag.
Come on, let's modify.
You don't think the 18's gonna help you, cause they're not. No, they're nowhere near. Heck!
Oh, no.
Look, Dan!
I know they've modified the van.
Cookie, they've got fluoride. Well, looks like an end of communism. Aye.
Hey, where you going? I told you I ain't planning no pay for you.
A clip from the air team there. Remember, fingers on your buzzers. This is an open round now. Can anyone name me the four members of the air team? Ah!
Who's that? Frostrup.
Frostrup.
Mr. T.
Yeah.
No,
the
you're
face.
On your own. Yeah,
face.
Yeah.
Mr. T. Yeah.
The four members.
Yeah, yeah. So Mr. The T, face.
Pretty boy.
Pretty boy.
No.
Are you sure?
No.
He said pretty boy.
Anyone over there? Leo? Mark? No, not you, Mark, you know.
Well, I don't know till this day which character I was playing.
You know, I don't know either. What's the answer?
Hannibal Smith, Mr. T, Face, and I've forgotten the other one. What was it?
Hannibal Murdoch, Mr. T, Face.
Murdoch!
Yeah. Yeah. Unlucky, unlucky. All right, that's the end of the clip round. Let's go to George Dawes and ask him what the scores are.
Ardelia, I'm very disappointed. I went out and bought myself a baked potato, put it in the oven, wouldn't cook.
Next round's the club singer round. I'll explain after Mr. Vic Reeves, who should be seated here.
Hello.
There he is. He's going to sing a song in a club style, like a club singer might do it, Anthony, right? And you've got to guess what song it is he's singing. It's an open round, buzzing if you think you know the song he's singing. George, are you ready? What is this song?
I believe I can fly by R. Kelly.
Correct.
Correct. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
incredible.
That is quite incredible.
Quite incredible. So quick, I believe I can fly by RJ Kelly.
Let's hear that song sung properly. A beautiful song. It's a beautiful song.
RJ Kelly.
Well,
random light, like a lunar module, descend on a guest, fodule, fodule.
That's a nice one. Who's it going to be?
That was beautiful.
Say
it.
Huh?
Baby.
You nearly did.
Who am I?
It's either Frank Bruno or Mick Jagger. Mick Jagger.
Mick Jagger, is that right, Leo?
It is dead right. Oh, right. Yeah.
So let's go straight up to George Dawes and say, what are the scores, George Dawes?
Oh no, what have I done? Oh, I shouldn't have done that. I've done to myself. Oh, I should imagine you'll never have me back here again. Oh, I do apologise. I should never have done it. Mark's got 5, Ulrika's got 4.
That's how we celebrate that particular score, Ulrika. Watch out for that in the future. Well, next round is the Duff from Above round. I'm going to need all your help. If I could please, Anthony. And everyone else, of course.
Yeah.
In beckoning down the beautiful dove from above.
From above.
OK, so if you could coo, it will help him come down. Let's bring her down.
Down she comes from that old oak tree, but I suspect she's contracted VD.
The beautiful plump dove from above. Now, as you can all see, Anthony, as you can all see, written on the side of the dove, a categories of questions.
Bob.
Yes?
Can I just stop you there? I knew a dove once who worked as an oven cleaner. It was an oven dove.
Yes, the beautiful plump dove from above. And as I was saying, written the category of questions, I'm going to ask you each in turn to pick a category from the dove and answer a question thereon. All right? Now, I should just remind you, the hidden behind one of the categories is a very special prize indeed. And should you choose that category, you're going to hear this noise.
Iranu!
However, should you answer any question incorrectly, you'll hear this noise.
Uvar!
OK.
Mark, I enjoyed your Americana programme.
Thank you.
Very good indeed. America, the land of plenty. Did you get plenty while you were up there?
Oh, yes, he will have done.
He will have done because he's a love trombone.
Blowing your sexual bugle around the land of plenty.
It's a greasy love.
Mark, pick a category from the dove
from above.
Onions.
Well, Mark, this is a literal video, so we're going to have a look at a video now. It's a famous video by a pop star, singer, band, something like that. But we've taken off the lyrics and we've replaced it with some light-hearted music. You're going to guess what that song is. Let's have a look.
It looked like a particularly unattractive version of Margaret Thatcher.
Yes, we saw Maggie.
In a bed.
Yes.
So Maggie, in Wake Up Maggie.
What was the
Maggie
song?
Maggie May.
Maggie May, bye.
Let's do it.
Bye, we'll see. Let's have a look.
Is Matt right?
Late September, we should be back at school. I know I keep you in me, but I feel I'm being you.
Maggie May by Rod Stewart, the singer.
That's right.
Well done.
And he, of course, was a strutter.
Oh, wasn't he?
Of the former sort of. Now, Mariella, choose a category from the dove from above.
Mints. No, I'm a...
Mints.
Yeah,
mints.
No, it's a...
Mints. Where's mints?
Thank you very much, Anthony.
Mints.
Mints.
Mariella, can you tell me which is the odd one out? The Taj Mahal, the pyramids, the Hanging Gardens of Babylon, or Mount McTwatty Bollocks?
Well, I'm too. I think it's got to be Mount McTwatty Bollocks.
Of course it is!
Well done. That was difficult, though.
It's merely a fictional butter mountain.
Leo,
pick a category from the dove from above.
Butter.
It's butter.
Butter. It's butter.
No, now, but it's got to be butter.
Well done. Yeah. Very good.
She picks up all the adverts.
Yes, she's very good.
I can't believe it's not butter.
Isn't she quick?
She's auditioning.
Don't get her on Quick Fit Fitters. We'll never get out of here.
Butter.
Butter.
With the gift now, Leo, of international gesturing.
Internationally approved gestures. Like, no. That's hello.
Yeah? Well,
don't.
Where did I put the chicken?
Oh, phew, it's hot in here.
Yeah, it's hot. Yeah. It's hot in here. Can you demonstrate I don't understand?
Baby!
Ulrika, choose a category from the dove from above.
Could I have some liver, please?
Liver!
Iran.
Oh. Iranu indeed. Congratulations. You have won tonight's star prize.
Ulrika.
Ulrika, you've won tonight's star prize. Would you like to hand it over, Bob?
I will do, yes.
There you are, then.
Ulrika, well done. You have won tonight's star prize. It's after dinner mints.
There it is, there. Oh, yeah. It's a beautiful prize.
Oh, no.
Anthony, like any little child, you're trying to open someone else's present. Now, Ulrika, if you're worried about CDJ or whatever it's called, don't worry, it's been seeped in Domestos for over a week. 7 days. It's a lovely prize, enjoy it. I know you will.
Thank you.
Ulrika, complete this sentence. Tulips from...
Amsterdam.
No, 90p a bunch at my local shop. Right, that's the end of the Dove from Above round, so let's go straight up to George Dawes and say, what are the scores, George Dawes?
Why, I'm never gonna get to eat that baked potato, I'm telling you!
Ulrika's got 6, Mark's got 8!
Hey, Bob! What the? Bob! Do you remember the time we spent as window cleaners?
Oh, yes. I cleaned the top floor.
And I cleaned the bottoms.
I was up the ladder.
And I was up the Dove.
Yes. It's the quickfire round because it's against the clock. It's fingers on the buzzers. You're going to get quickfire questions. We don't know how much time we've got, but when the time's up, you'll hear this noise.
Have you ever been to a harvester before?
Yes, you will. Quickfire round. It's fingers on the buzzers. Want to see those fingers? Off we go. Who were the likely lads? Lamar.
James Byrom and Rodney Bewes.
Correct answer. Can you tell me what can't is short for?
What
Thompson?
I cannot.
OK, I'll ask someone else.
Can't is short for I cannot.
That's correct.
News at news at 10.
Lamar.
Is a news programme on at 10 o'clock in the evening?
No, incorrect. Bong is the answer.
On the buzzers, do cupboards open out or in? That's Thompson.
Out.
No, I was speaking from the perspective of a trapped cat. Unlucky.
What? What time is it when both hands face upwards?
That is Thompson again.
Midnight or midday?
No, it's time to hand over the money, buddy.
Who directed Rowan Atkinson's feature film, Bean? Lamar.
Mel Smith.
He did, you're right.
Why do men wear mustaches?
Have you ever been to a harvester before?
Hey? Ah. That's the end of the round, that's the end of the quiz! So, George Dawes, what are the final scores?
It's
winner with 12 points, it's Mr. Mark Lamar! Oh!
Mark
Lemoore. Mark Lovely Lemoore. American fanatic Mark Lemoore, the sexual mountain. And mountain of sex. You have won tonight. Will you select somebody, Mark, from your team?
Yes.
To play the final game. Who's it going to be?
It's going to be Tanya.
Tanya!
So, Tanya, would you join me now as we stroll over here and play Make Up Shake Up? Stand over there. And here to my left is Brother Mortimer, who will tell you about it.
Thank you, Brother Vic. Can I first of all ask you, Tanya, to take a seat on this platform here?
Take a seat on this...
Careful.
Take a seat on this agricultural-style platform, which is based on the life of Snoop Doggy Dog.
It's and, very you know, it stable. Sums up,
it isn't stable. That's the point. Now, Tanya, what's happened is you've won a couple of tickets for a night cricket match,
uh-huh.
right? And there's a reasonable chance you might meet, say, Graham Gooch or Boyks or perhaps even Alan Lamb, can you imagine? So you're going to want to look your best, and to calm those nerves before meeting Gucci, you're going to want to... Oof. You're going to want a drink, and I've chosen stout. Now, we're going to ask you to apply some makeup so you look groovy and to drink the drink. But, as always, there's a catch. Brother Vic.
There is a twist, Brother Mortimer.
There is a twist because this crazy platform's going to start vibrating and you're going to put the makeup on, applying to your lips and the blusher to your cheeks.
That's okay. Right.
You'll get £10 for each area that you do, yeah. So you can, you'll get for the cheeks and the lips £30.
£40. £40. No, what? Just the cheeks and the lips. Come round the front, Lee.
Oh, you got another cheek round there. I didn't know.
And what would you buy with £40 if it came to you?
Some very expensive leggings.
Well, that's just an idea.
You don't have to buy leggings, of course,
Tanya. Thank you, Bob.
Well, we don't know how much time you've got, but I'll invite you to take the bitter in your left hand.
Okay.
You've got the lipstick, that's good.
Yep.
You've anticipated the nature of the task. Are you ready, Tanya?
I'm ready.
The lips and the cheeks, the brush is there when you need it. When the time's up, you'll hear this noise.
Gary, you prennit.
Nice one. So, let's make up and shake up! Oh, no, get the lipstick back!
More lipstick!
She's not gonna
get it! Gary, you prennit.
And see how she did. She's drunk the bitter, so she's going to be relaxed. Gucci's going to like that. But let's have a look at the makeup.
Well, she's applied it to both cheeks.
Look at the blusher.
She looks like someone from Duran Duran.
Yeah. Imagine that. That's £20, but the lips, no way. That's £20, Tanya.
£20!
Come and join us. Come and join us.
Catch more Shooting Stars next Friday at 9:30 here on BBC Two.